Dodge County Sheriff Steve Fitzgerald. How you doing,
right.
Sheriff? Nice to see you out here this afternoon. One of the
big
brand new cars.
Steve.
And across the way, we have one of the new, I think those are arrows that the Highway Patrol is using now. And they need them for high-speed chases, Jory.
We don't want to be involved with that, though.
But I remember hearing
leading.
Some news about the Camaros that the troopers are driving, and boy, I tell you, they are snazzy little cars. Our first big unit, Jory, is a motorcycle unit.
Right, the Zor Nomads, and they provide colorful and exciting entertainment with their precision motorcycle riding, and they're doing that right now. Though they're based in Madison, they have members from many parts of the state and from many walks of life, and this may include policemen, lawyers, engineers, businessmen. And did you know that each one purchases his own identical machine and they maintain them themselves? This year, the Nomads are riding Suzuki 450 motorcycles. They do have weekly drill sessions to achieve the precision and the riding speed. Their summer schedule starts in May and it continues into October, and it takes up most of their weekends and holidays, so they're really a very dedicated group. Proceeds are used to cover expense of transporting the motorcycles and also contributions to the Shrine Burn Centers and the Orthopedic Hospitals that are across the country. In front of us right now, John.
They certainly are.
They're a little noisy.
They're a precision routine. If you've seen any parades in the area, you've probably seen the Zor Nomads. They've been performing in parades in our area for many, many years, riding those sharp Suzuki motorcycles. They're wearing white shirts, dark slacks, and the yellow stripes, original motorcycle boots, and the old, police officers still wear those kind of helmets.
I think they do, for sure.
When they ride a motorcycle. Most of the cycles have flags on them, and the way they execute this is a couple of the cyclists will come up and take the stationary position, and the rest will Sesquicentennial banner, and it'll be a little while before they reach us. And golly, I'm just looking forward to seeing this entire parade. 19 musical units will be parading in front of us very shortly, and that's got to be more musical units than you can see. Probably about 99% of the parade for the size of the
right. So maybe while we're
waiting
for this unit to get up to us, you can tell about some of the activities that are going to be happening on Sunday, because there are just tons of things going on tomorrow, and we don't want any of you to miss any of them. There will be a tour of historical Beaver Dam buildings, and buses are available, which I think is really great. You don't have to worry about parking, that type of thing. And on the tour will include the Geezy home that's located at 511 North Center. Now, that home was owned by Ann Rogers Pfeffer, who passed away within the last year or two, and was purchased by Mr. Geezy, and he has restored the entire home, furnished it, and I understand it's just beautiful. I want to make sure and get over there tomorrow. But those tours will be going from 1 to 4 p.m. tomorrow. And if you want to take the bus ride, they're just $1. You take your ticket and you can get on and off between the locations. And those locations will be Whalen Academy for the Festival of the Arts, Swan City Park, where there are various activities going on that we'll talk about a little bit later, the Geezy Home, and then also the Dodge County Historical Society in downtown Beaver Dam. Now, if you want to tour the Geezy Home, there is a charge for that of $3. So the bus tour and the entry to the Geezy Home would total $4 if you want to take the entire tour. And that's going on from 1 to 4 tomorrow afternoon.
Dory, I was a little bit remiss. The very first unit in the parade, and I don't know if you mentioned this, I don't think we did, was the Beaver Dam Flying.
Right.
You went by and gave us a little wave. A parade to remember. The flag is going by us now. A banner being held by about six youngsters, I would say, pre-teenage, are holding the banner. And as they pass, now the color guards are coming up, and all of the people along the parade route are rising to salute our flag. And what a fantastic year to have this with the feeling of patriotism that is flowing throughout the country now since the war against Iraq. And you see, you get a more of a feeling of patriotism than you have. Units. We had the Cub Scouts Flag Patrol, Boy Scouts Color Guard, and Beaver Dam well as the Beaver Dam Legion color drive.
Right. A little bit of this music.
As they pass us by, Dory, that was the 84th Division Band.
And there from Milwaukee, the Army Band is the oldest band of all branches of service and tradition we leave behind the color guard. There are 33 members, and they'll be eating down at the park after the parade before heading back to Milwaukee. So you can go down there and meet some time to great job.
And this is the City of Beaver Dam float, which is approaching us now, being pulled by the Department of Public Works, one of their red and white bands. It's a trailer being pulled. 1941 to 1991, obviously, in honor of our Sesquicentennial, the 150th birthday of the Beaver Dam. Dory, I believe this float has been pulled in parades for a number of years.
Yes, I'm sure they have. I do recognize one person on the float, and that's Steve Ehlenfeld-Bostel. Of course, Steve's family is the first family for the Beaver Dam Sesquicentennial. So Steve is riding on this float.
Are you familiar with the procedure that was used to arrive at
the Beaver Dam? I believe the families had to enter, fill out a blank sort of a form, and enter this, and then they were chosen depending on their background, and it was required, I believe, that they were at least three generations Beaver Dam residents, and certainly the Ehlenfelds go way back in history here in Beaver Dam. The float is very pretty. It's red, white, and blue, very patriotic, with two flags on the front. Being pulled by the public
truck. Dory, maybe we can pick up some more of the music from the 84th Division playing band. They're going to be passing the dignitary reviewing stand in a very short while, and I'm sure many of the units will be performing up there. Hopefully we can pick it up. Well, they're heading a little bit far up the street. That's about to pick up music. As fine music as we possibly can.
I haven't.
That is an excellent movie,
excellent.
And it tells a little bit about firefighting, and I hope you get an opportunity to see that.
I'll certainly try. We have State Representative Bob Getch, and he's walking. He didn't take the easy way out and ride in the car. He's actually walking the entire parade, and I think that's great.
And he is dressed, decked out in his Sesquicentennial uniform from, well, back, I guess, in the 1850s, I guess you'd say that's how it was popular for.
Yeah.
Little hat, the brown jacket.
Right.
What is it? It's a shirt, but it's got a lot of ruffles on it, a bib hanging out.
With a ruffle and a bib. And he is escorting Marianne Miller, and she's all decked out in a beautiful pink gown with a white hat, picture hat, back from bygone days. Kind of fun to dress up that way, I would guess.
And the parade is stopped momentarily, and I'm sure it'll be stopping and starting from time to time because of the Zora Nomads, which we described to you that were leading it. Their routine just stopped. Bob?
Hello?
How are you? Oh, it's nice to see all of your friends out here.
Right.
You get to know, you know, being in our business story, it's really nice because you get to know so many people.
That's right.
One of them now is the Sesquicentennial Liberty Float. It has a picture or a representation of the Statue of Liberty surrounded by flowers, followed by the state of Wisconsin flag and the U.S. flag. And it says on the side, red, white, and blue, Beaver Dam Sesquicentennial, 1841 to 1991.
It's a beautiful float. And then following is a unified Catholic schools band. And, of course, they incorporate three schools here in Beaver Dam, St. Patrick's, St. Michael's used to have a school, and St. Peter's. And from the three parishes are members in this band. And they're all decked out, and I'd say it's a royal blue, gold, and white.
Mm-hmm. And
very attractive.
First of all, they have four young ladies, and I believe there's a young man up there holding their banner. They immediately precede their color guard, which they have a flag of the state of Wisconsin, which, by the way, was founded in 1848, not too far from the founding of Beaver Dam, right, Doris Ann?
Right.
And the color guard has their white helmets on, and as Dory described the uniforms, and they're followed by the flag twirlers, and there must be, I would say, close to 8 or 10 of those flag twirlers holding their flags, and I wish they'd start the band up and get them playing for us so we could put some of their music
on the air.
For,
well,
yeah.
Hopefully that's what they're trying to do. In the meantime, let's tell you, as part of Beaver Dam Sesquicentennial Celebration, the women's affiliate to the Beaver Dam Area Chamber of Commerce is proud to present Blast from the Past. It's a costume style show from 1820 to 1920. Enjoy the costumes from the past at the band shell in Swan City Park tomorrow at 12 noon. And then after the show, the models will circulate for your closer viewing enjoyment. You'll also be able to ask questions about the models through your dress in case of rain, which of course it's not going to do, but then the show would be moved to the Beaver Dam Mall at the same time, 12 noon. And from a couple of gals that saw this show down in the Milwaukee area, that's where the group is from, they said it shops really great, especially all of you ladies out there will enjoy this. So get down to Swan City Park tomorrow noon for that costume show. And then immediately following is the WBEV WXRO Beard Contest.
Yes, I understand. We have over 40 entrants in there.
Yeah, it's closer to 50 right now because I picked more up this week, and we really have a lot of guys participating.
To be honest, we were concerned if we were going to have enough to have a contest.
Well, we certainly are, and there are many different categories, and we have the trophies. The big guy went out and bought some really neat trophies that we're giving away, and we might mention the other two sponsors of that beard contest, our weekly Winklers Family Hair Care Center, spit it out, and also Jerky's Corner, and we certainly thank them for helping us sponsor the contest.
That's right, and that'll be at Swan Park tomorrow at
judges?
No, I am not one of the judges. Some of the folks from Winkley's are going to be. some of the folks from Winkler's are going to be judging that.
Yeah, I think they have three judges, yes, and then I believe Karen, one of the Gurkies, Dale's wife, is also a judge, and I believe maybe someone from the station might be judging, too, so we'd have five judges.
I know Frank Barris will be emceeing that tomorrow afternoon at Swan Park. And, you know, talking about Swan Park, there are some activities down there this afternoon which we touched on, and one of them is the Sesquicentennial Hospitality Center, which you can visit immediately following the parade. Swan Park is just such a gorgeous setting. I was by there again last Sunday, dropping a friend off after fishing while the Arts and Crafts Fair was going on. What a gorgeous setting for any kind of event. We can be really proud of that park in many parts we have here in the city of Beaver Dam. But on to what's happening at the park after the parade. They'll have the Hospitality Center sponsored by the Beaver Dam Hospitals, and the 1st Brigade Band will perform at 3 p.m., and we'll be telling you a little bit more about them as the parade goes on here. Now here comes the Unified Catholic Parish Band passing us by. You can hear the drums, but unfortunately, they're not playing. They're going to save that for the Dignitary Stand, which is up the street about a half a block where we're located. We'll let you listen to some of the drum music. Followed by the adult volunteers who help follow them along the parade route with water bottles and the like. Yeah, I think it was George Durfee. George Durfee, one of the dignitaries here, just got squirted by the water bottle. And they're really a sharp looking unit.
Yes, they are.
See him again.
Big promoter for the city of Beaver Dam.
Yeah, he's always out promoting the city of Beaver Dam, and just one of the nicest guys you're going to find.
We have a couple more cast mayors that are coming up next. The next one's going to be Vi Schneider. She was mayor from 1980 to 1984. And then following her, we'll have Elvin Beers. And Mr. Beers really was mayor for a great number of years. He was mayor from 1950 to 1954, and again,
she's doing some promoting to Beaver Dam from the back of her convertible. Mayor Schneider was not the first. How you doing, Mayor? Was not the first woman mayor of Beaver Dam.
Mary Spellman.
Mary, I know her name was Mary Spellman, but I don't remember when she was mayor.
Way back. Even before our time, Johnny.
I believe Mary Spellman's picture is still up in City Hall. Now Mayor Alvin Beers is passing us by, and the dignitaries in front of us are standing for Mayor Beers. He served three separate terms, as Dory explained. For 16 years he was mayor, longer than anyone else in the history of our city. And you know, one of the first things I remember about Mayor Beers was he initiated, "I will plant a tree in 73. It was a tree planting program we had in Beaver Dam, where people were encouraged to plant trees between the sidewalk and the border.
And that was a good plan.
And then the next year I went back to do a news story with him, and I said, "Well, what about 1974? And the mayor said, "We will plant no more in 74. Now we have the Chamber of Commerce quote, Doris.
Yeah, the ambassadors are writing the quote. At least many of them are. And they have a replica of the spring house, which is down there at Swan City Park on the quote. And I must say, it is gorgeous. It's all done in green, purples, and white. And it's a sight to behold.
far preceding one of the real highlights of the parade this afternoon, if there is such a thing. This is it. The Beaver Dam Golden Beavers Marching Band, just back from Washington, D.C., where they won a couple of trophies. As a matter of fact, one of them, the best unit in the July 4th parade in Washington, D.C.
Yes, they were the Presidential and the Grand Marshal Sweepstakes Award. So they returned to a hero's welcome here in the Beaver Dam.
Literally thousands of, at least 1,000 Beaver Dam residents that were down here.
Yes, I believe that. They're just a great unit, and they are so sharp-looking, and they're green and gold. You have to see it to appreciate it.
It wasn't too many years ago that they purchased those uniforms.
That's right. We might mention Andrea Volsky, Angie Lupo, and Kathy Wickland are the drum majors. And Becky Riley and Denise Beaver are the flag corps captains.
And they're just now beginning to pacify. And you can hear the applause. People really cheering this group of young people on. You know, this wasn't the first time that we've seen that. But just,
that is holding up a big banner behind us.
Someone, yes, they've unfolded the banner behind us. Let's listen to them.
Music rental organ. I believe they'll be playing down at Swan Park after the
right. promoting that. They're dressed in centennial fashion, sesquicentennial fashion. Who is this we have here?
So this is the past Beaver Fest chairman, and this Beaver Fest of 1990. Very zealous, and we have...
Jeff Kitchen is on the float.
Tom Sprague.
And Miss Beaver Fest 1990 is riding along. Little Miss Beaver Fest. She's picked in a pageant held out at the Beaver Dam Hall.
Right.
Correct?
Now, this year, of course, that was discontinued because this year we have the Sesquicentennial.
Oh, that's
she's
right.
From 1990.
Here comes our first drum and bugle corps, Dory. The Racine Scouts, drum and bugle corps, marching up the street right now.
They're coming off a rebuilding year, and they're taking us through space today. The four repertoire includes Mars and Jupiter and the Battlestar Galactica. They have 60 members. I believe Kathy Gerson spoke about this earlier. Support staff, support drivers, instructors, transport motorcycles, buses, semi trailers, and all decked out in a royal blue, white, and red. Very impressive looking. They, of course, will be competing tonight.
I love those silver helmets with the red plumes.
Yes.
I get the chill.
Yeah.
We've seen Scouts Drum and Bugle Corps just passing us by. Now we have Miss Beaver Dam, 1966.
And that is Phyllis Housley. She was also Dodge County Air Show Princess back in 1966. She's in a car driven by Peter Seifel. And Phyllis was recently in Beaver Dam for the Indian History Celebration. Phyllis won the Miss Beaver Dam contest in 1966 during the 125th celebration.
And she's riding in, that's a 57 or a 58 Chevrolet two-door convertible. Boy, that is one classic car that a lot of people would just love to own. Black and chrome, basically.
We're seeing a lot of antique cars, and they all look great to me, but I don't know one from the other.
Well, I recognize the 57s and 58s, because all my friends had them back in the 60s, and they were constantly in the garage working on them.
Well, now we have a mini car from Richard's Insurance. It's a miniature 1910 Model T Ford, and it is owned by the Richard's Agency. It's used in parades and as a pace car for miniature races in the Midwest.
You have about 3 pages of notes on this next one.
Well, this is the American National Bank float, and in front of the float is a convertible. In it riding President Edward M. Jacobs and his wife, Mary Ann. And then this float was designed and made by the American National Bank employees, and if we take their 100th anniversary, they're celebrating their 100th anniversary this year. And there is a coin at the top that has 100 years on one side and a Sesquicentennial theme on the other side. The employees are dressed in period costumes, and they have them specially made for this event and for their celebration.
There must be 25 employees. Describe the outfit. They're all dressed exactly the same.
Okay,
and they're
wearing
blue and white umbrellas.
They have black skirts and kind of a rose-colored waistband and white blouses, and then a pink over and a black print, and then they have the bonnet on. And they actually are doing a routine.
Now, this is the Beaver Dam Women's Club.
No, no. This is the American National Bank doing this routine. These are all employees, and don't you have to give them a lot of credit?
You bet.
While to get this down.
Sharp looking unit.
Yeah, and
they have some men in the background wearing in the back, four of them, with canes and suspenders.
What do you call those visors they're wearing? They were used.
It's a dealer's visor.
Okay.
That's what a car dealer wears.
All right. Very impressive.
Well, now we have a couple of tractors passing us by. First of all, an antique John Deere. Can we pick up the putt-putt? This is a two-cylinder. Sometimes you'll see them, but they obviously won't have them in the parade with the old steel wheels on them. And then we have a newer John Deere tractor, 720 diesel in the parade. Of course, we can't forget the agricultural community, such an important part of the local economy. And, of course, the big Farm Progress Days event that was held in Dodge County this past week.
couple of antique autos going by, and riding in them are members of the Beaver Dam Women's Club. They're riding in a 1928 Hudson. That's one of them. Ruth Tucker is the president. Mabel Kellum, a longtime Beaver Dam resident, is in one of the cars. And Sandra Andrews, she's secretary treasurer for this Women's Club.
All right, and as they pass us by, coming up next is a unit that will be performing in Swan Park. Why don't we listen to some of the music and maybe you can squeeze in some of your notes on them as
okay.
They pass by. But we do want to give the folks an instrument. Geese, wooden carved geese, each of them on their own little wagon. wagon sitting on the grass. So at the end is a cracked egg.
And next we have Dodge County's Miss Snowflake.
Michelle Bibbing.
Right.
Dodge County Snow Queen. Michelle. Riding in a very, very nice looking black convertible.
Another drum and bugle corps is coming upon us now, and that's Royal Airs from St. Louis, Missouri. And they were founded back in 1985. And for the first 3 years, they entertained and competed as a drill and drum corps. And with the addition of a brass line in 1989, the Royal Airs were ready for a whole new audience.
Little motor scooters, and I believe they're going to do a drill here, hopefully for the big carries. And each of the
maybe
by some
when this is over, we might want to ride somewhere.
Triple E Mavericks is what it says on their...
Flags on all scooters, very patriotic.
And they are going to perform their routine now, which is very difficult to explain on the radio.
Yes, it is.
We'll just tell you that they're doing a whole bunch of zigzags and riding around in front of us.
And all little red scooters. Flag, color guard, and two drum majors. Rose has invited the entire group to Rose Wooden Wheel for lunch following the parade.
Let's listen to it. White dressing uniform. Let's see if they're going to take a look at this. There we go. about a trucking company truck on a large semi. They have a depiction of some of the scenes that some of the scouts enjoy.
It's okay for Trey, scouting history in Beaver Dam. Community activities of scouting from the 1920s through the 1980s. And they're in Syrian uniforms, and the banner contains all of the scouting laws.
Okay, and some of the scouts marching behind. Up on my program. Oh, here's Scott Kluge, our 2nd District Congressman. Former TV news announcer. Patting some of the youngsters on the head. Scott carrying his own youngster around. Now we have, following Scott, the Wisconsin State Color Guard Champions. They've won it in about 5 years between 86 and 90.
They're from Appleton, Wisconsin.
Sponsored by the American Legion Poll.
Thank you, Mayor.
Oh, the mayor brought us a wooden nickel. Thank you, Mayor Kahelski.
Right, on the back of it, it says, Beaver Dam, Wisconsin, 1841-1991, Sesquicentennial. So those are souvenirs to keep forever.
The applause you hear is for that color guard that is going to do a little bit of a routine in front of us. Carrying bags. Their own Legion unit flag, the flag of the United States, and the Wisconsin flag, and a POW-MIE flag.
Missing in action.
Is completing its performance, and they stopped to perform for the dignitaries here, and actually turned to the side of the street and gave them a salute. You can probably hear the gentleman hollering out orders. And as they continue up the street now, what a parade going.
This is great.
That is a vehicle that's associated with that color guard unit. It's called the Scotland Guard, Post 38, American Legion, Appleton, Wisconsin.
And you can hear all the applause for them. The viewers are most appreciative of all of the units in the parade.
Beaver Dam Girl Scout Float is coming up next, Doris Ann, and its theme is Through the Years with Girl Scouts. And that is just, it's a pickup truck pulling a large trailer loaded down.
With a lot of Girl Scouts,
there
right?
Must be 50 on there.
That's a lot.
Some of the signs they carry say the world of today and tomorrow.
Happy birthday, Beaver Dam.
The world of outdoors, of the outdoors, I should say.
The world of the arts, the world of today and tomorrow, the world of people.
Girl Scouting's been with us a long time, and hopefully will be with us a long time in the future as well. Very well-behaved young ladies on that floor. Some of the things I would imagine that they study, the world of people, the world of arts, the world of well-being. For trained scouting throughout the years. And there are some timepiece uniforms in there as well, period uniforms, some of the older ones. Great to see. Girl Scouts of Beaver Dam. Now we have Senator Barb Lorman. He is the senator representing our area, walking up the streets behind the car, decked out in flags and sign explaining exactly who she is. She's from Fort Atkinson. I've had an opportunity to talk to Senator Lorman over the years. Very, very nice lady. She's been serving in the Senate for a number of years now.
Very gracious person.
She is. A Republican, I should add. Have you had any Democrats in the parade, Dory? You want to keep the seat?
I know.
Hi, Barb. Nice to see you here this afternoon. And she's coming over to...
The mayor's going to get a big kill. We now have the Beaver Dam Community Hospital float. And let's tell you a little bit about that. On the float, children of employees, and they are Laura Levenhagen and Mark Schachter. Both are 10 years old, and the
boat is being pulled by a 1948 Chevy pickup that's owned by Tom Sandbloom and driven by Dave Eggers, the major builder of the float. Dave is a hospital employee. And the medical symbol is on the float, and the children are dressed in scrub suits worn by physicians and nurses at the hospital in different departments.
Now we have the Hilltoppers drill team, and this is all young ladies first. Am I correct in saying that?
Yes. They are an all-girl group. They're Richland Center's teenage ambassadors, and they're award-winning. They've won over 375 trophies. They participated in Gimbel's Thanksgiving Parade in Philadelphia, Cheyenne Day's Parade out in Wyoming, the Indy 500 Parade, National American Bicentennial Grand Parade in Washington, D.C., and also the Cotton Bowl. And a past member lives in Beaver Dam, and that is Sue McConaghy. Bet you know Sue.
And they're doing their routine for the Beaver Parade in front of us, and the routine ends up, they're holding one of their young ladies up in the air, and she's holding an American flag. That's really phenomenal. And I would guess those girls range anywhere from 7 or 8 years old, maybe to the early teens, Dora?
Yes, I would say so.
And they have a very smart Australian bush hat with a white tube, blue trousers, and black shorts. And the cuffs and belts and sashes are white, with typical marching boots. Boy, they did a great routine for us here. Now, one little girl playing a tambourine in the back row.
She's a little girl.
She can't be more than 6 or 7 years old. I just love listening to that drum music.
You should have heard the drummer last night at the Kids from Wisconsin performance. Oh, it was great. In fact, the whole weekend, my 8-year-old grandson, Craig, wanted to go to the Brewer game last night. I told him, no, he had to go to Kids from Wisconsin with me. And afterwards, I said, well, Craig, what'd you think about it? And he thought for a minute, and he said, hey, I think I liked it better than the Brewer. So that was quite a compliment from an 8-year-old.
Right. Rocky Rococo. The Rocky Rococo Pizza is driving by. I think that's a Duesenberg, Dory. That is a very expensive antique car.
Oh, that's a beautiful car.
And Rocky Rococo, you've seen him on the ads on television, and I'm sure you've had some of his samples, some of his pizza here in Beaver Dam. He's doing his typical Italian accent and waving to the crowd in his white suit. Lawrence and Irma Gantz driving a 1929 Buick passing us by now. Do they have a radio in there? I don't think so.
I don't know. Did they have radios in those days in cars? I'm not sure. Thank goodness they do now.
The Hotel Rogers and Ovens of Brittany float is passing by, Doris Ann.
Oh, yeah. John Allen. Got to get that one in there.
Let's see. That several people dressed in period costumes. The two young ladies in front, one of them is Molly McQueen, whose mother is the manager of Ovens of Brittany, and the other one is her little cousin, Chelsea Moser.
Well, I wonder who she is. Any relative of yours, John?
She's waving to her mother, who is on stage next to me. She was so excited about, can you imagine being 6 years old and getting to ride on a float in a parade?
Well, just think, 56 years from now, she'll remember this as she's planning the, what would that be called, the bicentennial?
Yeah, 200.
Right.
Bicentennial. I remember the nation's 200th bicentennial.
Yes, I went to Washington, D.C. that year.
Beaver Dam Hockey and Figure Skating Association. Oh, do they have a nice float?
Yes.
Skating 150 years of Beaver Dam.
And it's 150 years of winter fun, and they're in 1840 costumes, and they're wearing antique skates. It's just a lovely float.
And they've done the float up so it looks like an ice rink.
Yes, it is. It's all silver.
Swan City Ice Skaters of Beaver Dam, part of that float. I want to talk about the quote that they'll be giving away a little bit later, but first we have a drum and bugle corps, Doris.
Right, the Blue Stars. They are from La Crosse, Wisconsin.
Let's listen to them.
Okay. Okay, they were founded back in 1964 as a color guard, and they expanded into an alternative field tour in 1966. They traveled across the nation as ambassadors of goodwill, representing the city of La Crosse, Wisconsin, a beautiful area. At the competition, they'll be performing music by Sandy Caddy and John Rutter. They are the 1989 DCI World Champions.
Do you know who Sandy Caddy is?
No.
She is a gospel singer who was featured, it was either in Boston or Washington, D.C. I believe she was featured in the Washington, D.C. July 4th celebration this year.
That's the music they are playing. And they, of course, will be in the competition this evening.
Now we have a nice Columbus Girls Choir. And the Knights of Columbus, of course, a Catholic organization. A couple of knights up there, all conducting their official uniform with one of the priests from St. Peter's here in Beaver Dam, riding the float as well. And the Knights of Columbus uniform is really neat. It's got an old admiral's hat, the old kind of hat that they used to wear.
Beautiful outfit.
The Navy in the 1850s.
Mr. Booty is one of those gentlemen on the float.
Right. Now we have the Friends of Beaver Dam Library. Some of them marching. Our Shared Heritage, 1841 through 1991. The board members are wearing T-shirts with famous American and English authors of the last 150 years. John Steinbeck.
And Pat Paul is bringing up the rear of the unit. She, of course, is our librarian.
Right, she's wearing the John Steinbeck T-shirt, one of our nation's famous authors. Very fitting tie-in for the Sesquicentennial celebration. Now the Beaver Dam Job's Daughters float. Being pulled by a Ranger pickup truck and a trailer carrying some of Job's daughters. What does it say on the side? Job's Daughters and Himalaya of Beaver Dam. In their traditional costume.
And next we have the Green Giant train. It represents the canned and frozen products that Green Giant produces. The Green Giant Company has plants in Ripon, Mayville, and Beaver Dam in our area. And in 1989, the Beaver Dam facility celebrated its 75th 25th anniversary.
The Jolly Railroad, it's called, from the valley of the Jolly Green Giant.
Cream-style corn and frozen beans.
Following up with his little sprout, who's not so little. It's a sprout
he's
a big
not.
Sprout costume. Now we have the Commercer Grein Fischstadt, which is a German unit.
And this is Roy and Joyce Gantz. They're from Beaver Dam, and they're in Pomeranian outfit. Pomerania is a country that is now a part of Poland.
Oh, my goodness, I said German.
But many Pomeranians came to this country starting in 1838, but the Gantz ancestors came over back in 1846, and the outfits are made of all wool. The blue border on the skirt represents the Baltic seas, and the silk scarf worn with the outfit has a rose on it that represents the national flower.
And that is the Gantz family.
And these are outfits back from 1846 era.
Great. Now the Beaver Dam Hockey Association is pulling that coat that they are raffling off. And the raffle
boat.
Tickets will be available at the Beaver Dam City Athletic Field after the parade this afternoon. That is a 15.5-foot fishing boat with the typical fishing seats and a 35-horse force engine. So if you're into fishing at all, you want to get some tickets on that. And riding the float are some very famous national champion hockey players who will be at the athletic field after the parade giving autographs between 3 and 4 this afternoon. And we'll tell you a little bit about them, but first we want to tell you about this next marching unit that's coming by.
Yeah, it's the Northmen from Green Bay, Wisconsin, so let's listen to them a bit.
It's a one-piece uniform with a cape.
Kind of looks like leaves, the cape effect.
I did want to mention those hockey players who will be giving autographs afterwards, and free autographs. Joe Harwell from University of Wisconsin, 1990 champions. Joe Frederick from the 91 Northern Michigan National champions. Jeff Marshall from UW Stevens Point, 91 Division III champions. And Paul Battledge, formerly with the Madison Capitals, and now with Colorado College. And again, they'll be at the City Athletic Field at 3 this afternoon, and immediately following the parade from 3 to 4, giving free autographs. So if you're into skating, bring the youngsters for an autograph. Now the Telltale Theater.
Right, they're presenting Wizard of Oz, and that performance will take place July 17th through the 21st at the Beaver Dam Community Theater. Judy Pierce is the director, and performances will be held each of those days, either at 2 or 7 p.m. or both of those times. And tickets are on sale right now at Century at $2 each. And then we have the car representing, do you remember, the Beaver Dam Community Theater. It's a three-act musical. It's the Beaver Dam Pageant. And, John, you saw that. You said it was excellent. In fact, you made a brief appearance in it.
Yes, I was in the play two nights. Pam Prewee is one of the participants riding on that convertible. And that play contains, through the course of the run, we'll have over 200 actors in it.
And
it
is the Beaver Dam High School principal is in this next horse-drawn cart.
I can't describe it.
It's beyond description, right?
And she is promoting Do You Remember as well, which will be put on at the auditorium at the high school tonight at 8 o'clock, tomorrow night at 6 o'clock. If you haven't seen it, get over and see it if there are tickets available.
Con Studio car with a couple of their students riding in the back of the convertible. And then we have the Cheese Nuggets.
And they are wearing costumes replicating Wisconsin dairy products. Large costumes, rather neat outfits.
We have the new Attitude Clown. I think those are the first clowns we've seen walking among the crowd, right?
Yes, it is. I'm amazed at how well this parade is going. I mean, there aren't really any breaks at all.
No pause. We're really keeping a good pace. We don't have a lot of legs, and that's great. We just got a high WBEV.
One of the clouds. And there's an antique automobile from Helbing Supper Club in Beaver Dam with a rumble seat in the back. American Legion baseball team, which were the state champions. Hi, guys. How you doing? We followed them through the state championships here on WBEV last year.
I would love to own a llama. And we have a 20 hitch from Stratford.
What is llamas?
Llamas. 20 hitch.
Tons of llamas pulling this.
Yeah, pulling a wagon. They are just, they're such an interesting animal.
I've never been this close to one. They're following Terry Kiefer, who is the coach from the Beaver American Legion baseball.
You know, if you ever drive over to Ryle, as I do occasionally, there are a couple of farms on the way where you drive by llama farms, and they're always out in the field, and they're just so much fun. They're just a neat animal.
Hey, the circus parade has got nothing on us. We got a 10-team llama here.
That's right.
Pulling a little wagon.
Have you ever seen the two llamas that are owned by the prize of the Columbus area, and they dress them up in tuxes and so forth? They attend weddings and the whole bit.
Here's a club with the American Legion. This is the softball team.
No, this is the girls' basketball team.
State runner-up Division I. We all remember the excitement they gave us down in Madison. All of the young ladies, or many of them, riding that float. Basketball team. I just wanted to talk about them a little bit more. I'll tell you, they provided so much pride for this community when they were performing in that state girls championship tournament and displayed such real ability to carry themselves so well.
Yes, they represented Beaver Dam very well. We heard a lot of comments on that.
Now we have a stitch in time.
That's from Nancy's Notions. Nancy's Notions float, and we have period sewing machines. The gals are decked out in costumes representing that area.
Or era. Whichever. Oh, there's a modern sewing machine. They're all computerized now.
It's a lot different than it used to be.
Yes. Of course, Nancy Zeman, if you're not familiar with Nancy's Notions, Nancy began that business. She's a Beaver Dam native, and she is seen nationwide on TV with Sewing with Nancy now.
Right. One time I was down in Fort Wayne, and I was flipping through the channels and ran across Nancy, who came back, and I mentioned that to her, and she said, oh, yeah, she believes she was in almost every state in the Union now.
She has a large shipping store in Beaver Dam, which employs many people.
He said, another redhead, greatest people in the world.
Dory Doris Ann, of course, known for her famous red hair throughout Beaver Dam. Sideshow band, Old Mapleton Circus Band from Oconomowoc, Wisconsin. And I've seen them in a number of parades in the area. They play circus music. They're riding in a truck, which is decked out like a circus wagon, and they're sitting on top just like a circus band wearing those types of uniforms.
They play the music of the great American tent circuses that were numerous in the U.S. between 1885 and 1930. And this bandwagon was handcrafted by Robert Ludwig, the band manager and the founder, and the truck is a 1934 Master Chevrolet.
Now we have a Risto antique fire truck. I think every fire department has
probably
fire
truck.
Yeah, that's great to see. Great to see folks from Risto up here. And following them is a little drill unit called the Risto Firecrackers. Now, these are youngsters, and I'm guessing they're 8, 9, 10 years old, maybe even a little bit younger than that. They are performing a little drill routine with a ladder. Now, this is done by drill teams of regular fire department story. I don't know if you're familiar with that, but these young people have picked up on that and are going to do a little drill for our dignitaries here with their ladders. Now they're putting the ladder down on the ground. Let's see what they do next. They're going to leave it laid there. Salute the dignitary. Well, they didn't quite catch the dignitaries. They got the crowd to the south a little bit, but they were mighty close. Great to see them. Now they're going to march ahead. And they have a Village Risto pumper truck following them. And they have their picnic coming up in the near future, Saturday, August 10th at Risto Fireman's Park. Get down there and enjoy those festivities. And now we have the Farm Bureau Queen, Cheryl Kavorkas, representing the Farm Bureau, riding in a snappy-looking little white convertible. Carrying swords, and as a matter of fact, one of them has a pistol there. And they are going to do a charge with a sword. One horse charged the other, and now two of them are in a sword fight. I've never done play-by-play for a sword fight before.
Well, something new.
Now he's taking on a second one. Can you imagine, you know, just from watching this, he's the gentleman doing battle on horses, how difficult that horse has been. My goodness, control your horse and still try to get it better than the other gentleman. That was really unique.
Yes, it was.
And there they go. Wheels with a buckboard, I guess, with about four seats on it, carrying some young people. Beautiful. Happy 150th. That's written on the front of a large semi truck that is pulling a teensy weensy little trailer behind. Grandpa Rechek's Sausage Express Intercontinental, it's called. What a gigantic. Drinking some milk and...
Do you think they'd share one of those summer sausages with us?
Yes, a freezer full of summer sausage. Of course, Rechek's known for their sausage. Home of Grandpa Rechek sausage.
Throughout the day. It's a softer type of music.
Yes.
I hope you were able to hear it.
And when they were playing it, it was like a march down the
stairs. They're wearing red great coats with blue trim.
With the traditional 1770s three-quarter hat.
Right. The Huracan Bank floats and it says happy birthday.
And they want to be a part of Beaver Dam community. Of course, they're just completing building their new bank here in Beaver Dam. Huracan State Bank established September 7, 1896. So they've been around for a while.
Yes, they have.
And their float is a replica of a couple of little bankers with an adding machine. And
very clever.
Really done well. A couple of teller's windows there, all done in gray paper, white and orange. Established 1896, Horicon State Bank in Beaver Dam, Burnett, Horicon, Iron Ridge, and the Ocean. They're around the area.
Outfit.
This is another Zora outfit, Zora Shrine. And that car that they have is a replica of a little, one of those little jail wagons you used to see on, well, the old Keystone Cop movies. Now they're blowing their whistles, trying to get, they've got the prisoner driving the wagon. Now the cops notice that.
Oh, my.
And they're trying to get him out. He's having
he needs a few driving lessons. Another prisoner appeared.
He got out of the back, too. Both of them have escaped from out of the rear of their little prison truck there.
Roar, Shrine, Keystone Cops, and the kids love it.
Now, next up, we have a fire truck. Fox Lake. Yes, this is the Fox Lake Historical Park.
And the Fox Lake Fire Truck. Riding.
94th Annual Dodge County Firefighters Tournament coming up August 12th. August 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th at Fox Lake. Charity Minders is the queen. And the fire truck is a 1936 Hirsch Pumper from the Fox Lake Fire Department, and that siren works as well. And you'll want to get up to that firefighters tournament for a good time August 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. Used to be on the water fighting team years ago. Not Fox Lakes, but Allen.
As part of Beaver Dam's Sesquicentennial celebration, the women's affiliate to the Beaver Dam Area Chamber of Commerce is proud to present Blast from the Past, a costume style show from 1820 to 1920. Enjoy the costumes from the past at the band shell in Swan City Park tomorrow at 12 noon. After the show, the models will circulate for closer viewing enjoyment. You'll also be able to ask questions about the model's period dress. And in case of rain, which of course is not going to happen, the show will move to the Beaver Dam Mall at the same time, 12 noon. All up there. Speaking of rain, I think it's moved on its way out.
Yes.
Because we have clear blue skies and we're getting a nice sunburn shot.
I don't think there's any problem with rain.
No.
Now we
left.
We have the Elk Grill here. We don't have a lot of information on this one, so we'll have to wait until their band passes by to get a little more. But again, it's a drum. They have a core drum and flag throwers out in front of them. White blouses, black skirts, green socks, white tennis shoes. They're doing their flag throwing routine at this moment. A couple of them carrying rifles as well. You can, of course, hear the drums in the background. We'll tell you where they're from, hopefully, when their band passes by. All of these units have trucks following them carrying their equipment. And,
yeah, all have green bows in their hair, wearing green necklaces, wearing green socks.
Very sharp looking unit.
Yeah.
And hand them the drum.
I would imagine there really used to be a problem when they are marching in very, very hot days. Long parade.
Well,
they must have that support.
So many of the adults walk alongside carrying water. The Elk Grill Lake Shore. Oregon, Wisconsin, their crop.
A lot of credit to all the adult chaperones that go along, chaperone these kids, march in all these parades, and they're really dedicated.
You want to get a hold of them? You can write Post Office Box 271, Mr. Boyd.
Okay.
Now we have an Indy 500 car.
Now maybe you can explain this. I don't know much about Indy 500.
Well, it's a car that can drive an Indy 500. Of course, there are other races now. I don't know if this is a gentleman.
Oh, this is Dan Steele.
Okay.
I recognize Dan.
Dan drove, and in a recent, his first entry of the year, he finished fourth.
Right.
And
he super was job.
Extremely pleased with that. And what an impressive looking little machine that is. Probably, how fast can go? A couple hundred miles an hour?
Would you like to drive one of those just once?
I always wanted to be a race car driver. And I did once in Columbus.
And how'd you do?
I bumped Norm Gray's car in the rear end and knocked him out of the race.
Oh, well, that's how you get rid of your competition.
Now we have a
horse-drawn wagon from Walmart. Representing Walmart.
Bill Zahn of Juneau, I believe he owns that wagon. And behind that, a horse unit. Now, that's a Conestoga. It's gone up in a Conestoga fashion, that wagon. I think we're a little out of order here, though.
Yeah, they were supposed to be a little bit earlier in the parade, so
we had a couple of
changes along the way.
Young ladies riding some gorgeous-looking horses, and have a young fellow riding a little pony there, too, following that horse-drawn wagon. Here's the Catholic Knights Insurance Society horse-drawn wagon, a source of financial security for Catholic families and a commitment to human caring. Catholic Knight Insurance, Branch 48. And a young lady pulling a coaster wagon. And that's what Tom Newman, who, one of the organizers of the parade, told us about. that bucket and scoop shovel is there for a reason.
Yes. The marching units do not want to march through the leavings.
Now Nellie's float is coming by. Over 60 flavorful years. And of course, Aunt Nellie's local plant in Kleiman, Wisconsin, just a few miles down the road. Had a few of their employees decked out as various vegetables, and then a farm scene being pulled by a garden tractor, that farm scene on a trailer with some tractors and some samples of the vegetables. And now we have another clown unit that's coming in droves to us.
For a while we didn't see clowns, and now this is really a nice group of clowns on bicycles.
Yes.
Well, look at this one. He has a three-wheel bike, but he's riding on two wheels.
That's right.
What kind of bicycle would you call this?
A weird one.
That is weird.
It has the handlebars about 10 feet in front of the gentleman that's driving it. And he's driving it by a steering wheel mounted where the seat would be, and the seat is mounted to the rear of that steering wheel.
Another redhead, John.
Yes. And here comes a bicycle with some bent axles, and it is rotating not sideways, but up and down. And that doesn't have handlebars. That has a steering wheel, too. I'd like to try riding that sometime.
Good exercise, I'd say.
Now another drum and bugle. Well, is this a marching band? The Royal Stars. Do we have any information on them, Dory?
No, I don't believe we do.
A couple of young ladies carrying the banner, designating them, of course, as the Royal Stars. They're from Hartford, the Hartford Royal Stars. And this is a pecan twirling. That's what it is. They're pecan twirling. With a little color guard leading them, carrying the flag, of course, and a couple of four young men with their
royal blue, gold, and white
rifles. And now these pecan twirlers in their white blouses and blue skirts.
And white then following pants. Them will be the Hartford City Dance.
Yes.
They're going to play for us.
Let's listen to that, Dory. But the wooden wheels are really being supported by some rubber wheels.
Modernized just a bit.
Right, and a buckboard following that. And then another horse unit, the Elks Lodge 1540, the Perks Family Farm from Ohio, Wisconsin. They have a two-horse hitch pulling the whole family the way it looks in their wagon.
I see Cecil Stebbins on the wagon.
Thank you.
Sesquicentennial Parade Committee coming up on their float.
Oh, there's a pink and green acres. Not to be associated with the people on the Beaver Dam Sesquicentennial float.
No. And those committee chair people include Rudy Gaetan, Tom Newman, and Cheryl Glasgow. Big thank you goes out to them for this stupendous parade. And their committee. Let's not forget all the people that helped.
They did a great job. This was a fantastic parade. Still more to come. Extend a big thank you to them on behalf of everyone doing the parade and all the citizens of Beaver Dam this afternoon.
Right.
So a 2-hour parade.